Good morning, students. In today's session, we are going to study about the next topic, that is inline function. In our previous session, we studied about what is function overloading, how to declare a function overloading, what is the need of function overloading, then restrictions of function overloading. Okay, so these things we have studied in a previous session. So in our today's session, we are going to study about the another function which is called the inline function. So till now people have studied that what is member function. Member function is nothing but it is a type of function which has been defined inside the class. Once again I will revise you people that function is nothing but it is a group of statements to perform a specific task and return a single value. It is a set of statements. Function is nothing but a set of statements which will be united in a group and it will be used to perform a specific task and return a value. So here we have so many categories of function. So in that, among that, so one of the function is inline function. So inline function is a function which is expanded inline. Which is expanded inline means, so instead of executing, instead of sending the control to the location where exactly it has been present, so what this function will be do, it will copy the whole code where the function has been called. For example, see here. So generally what we will do, we are going to write the main function. So here we have used a class called cube. See here, class cube int a equals 3. So this is a program to find the cube of a number. Okay. So here class cube int a equals 3. So already I am initializing the a value as 3. So here I am writing the function, so which is a member function of this class cube. So here cube, so this is the member function inside the class. So return a into a into a. Cube means we are going to multiply that number twice. So here we are multiplying. So where exactly this value will be written? Whenever the function will call. So from where we are calling the function? From the main function, right? So here this is the main function. Cube is a class name. B is the object. Object to which the class has been defined. So next, see how the cube of a number. So as soon as it will break, the function is calling here b dot cube. So what this object will do? The control will send here. It will send to the function where exactly it is present. Okay, whenever this b dot cube is there, so in that place, so the control, whatever our control, computer control is there, so that control will be sent to that particular location where exactly the function is present. So there it will perform the task. Okay, after performing the task, again it holds the value and get back here. What is the answer of this? 3 into 3 into 3, it is 27. So 27 will be printed here. So that's what actual execution will be takes place. But in case of inline function, so instead of sending the control, what it will do? So whenever we are mentioning this as an inline function, suppose if here if I am writing the inline. So for this function, so before just I am preceding the inline as a word. So as soon as I am preceding the inline word to this cube, so whatever whenever the calling function will be called, so the whole code, whole set of statements will be replaced here. You think whatever the code is there for that particular function, that will be copied and directly it will be replaced to the place where exactly it will be present. So this is called an inline function. So hence the another meaning of inline is expansion. Expanding. Expanding means where it is present, wherever itself it is going to be expanded scope. Okay. So from the calling function will not go to directly to the function. Instead of that, it will get the code, it will substitute there itself and find the result and will get the answer at the same time. So that here we will not get any difficulty, no complexity will be arise, the code will remain compact. Okay, so this is what the inline function. So what are the advantages of this inline function? So as I said that, so inline function will make our function as a compact. So this function for function is a, it is an efficient code, so it can be generated. Whatever the code we are writing, so that code can be generated efficiently. So then readability will be increased. So because it will be somewhat simple, okay, compared to other programs. So whenever we are using the inline function, it will remain compact. The programs will remain compact. Hence, the readability will be increases. Okay, so the thing only what we have to do is, so here whenever we are declaring a function, to that function just we are using a keyword called inline. Okay, so before the function name, just we are adding the keyword called inline. As soon as we will add this keyword inline, so that particular function will become an inline function. Okay, so where the expansion will be takes place when it will be called, so that is called a inline function. So we have another one function, so that is called friend function. Okay, already people know what is the meaning of friend, is it not? The friend has the access, right, to access private and the protected things, is it not? Suppose whatever your secrets will be there, who knows those secrets, so your friend is knowing. Like that, here also we have three access specifiers. So already we have discussed in the previous class, that is in classes and objects, that so we have three access specifiers. Which are those three access specifiers? Private, public and protected. Okay, so what do you mean by private? Private means those are the data members at the member function to which it has been declared as private, can be accessed only by that class, within the class. Okay, it cannot be accessed outside the class. If it is protected means it can be shared between the parent class and the child class, that is the base class and the derived class. So that is called the protected access specifier. Public means those member functions or the data members can be accessed anywhere in the program. Anywhere means it may be outside the function, it may be inside the class, or it may be inside the program, it may be outside the program. Anywhere in the program it can be accessed, those things. Okay. So the thing is, private and protected. Private can be accessed only within the class. Outside the class, they can't be accessed, right? So next we have protected. Protected can be shared only between the parent and the child class. Okay. So other classes, they can't access that. So in order to overcome that difficulty, so we have another function. So that function is called friend function. Okay. So what is the job of this friend function? So whenever we are declaring the function as a friend, so that function will be accessed. That can function can be able to access both the private data members and the protected data members and the member function of the class. So here the syntax for this friend function is friend return type function name argument list. So here also we are doing the same thing. So before giving the name of the function, just we are replacing a keyword. Just we are placing a keyword called friend. For inline function, we are placing a keyword inline. That function will become inline function. Okay. So here, in case of friend function, before the function name, just we are placing a keyword that is called friend. So then that function will become a friend function. Okay. So here, this friend function, this is a general syntax for friend function. Suppose if I want to make that new function as friend, so just I'm writing friend. Return type is a void. Just I am writing void as a return type. Cube. Okay. So here parameter just I am writing integer. So now this cube function will become the friend function, so that it can access the private data members and the protected data members of the class. Okay. So what are the advantages of this friend function? So this is a non-member function. Friend function is a non-member function. Friend function of a class. Whatever the class, non-member function means it is not a member of the class. Whatever the function we are creating, so that function is not a member of the class. For example, if I am creating the class, okay, class cube. So here I am writing void get data, then void display. Okay, these two functions are called members of the class cube. These are the member functions of the class cube. But here I have not written the cube class, cube function. Okay, so hence the cube function will become the non-member function. Okay, so because that we are writing as a friend. Okay, so it is a non-member function of the class, so that it can be accessed the private members and the protected members. That is also one of the advantage. So it can be called using object of the same class. So if you want to call, we are using the object of the whichever the class friend function. Okay, not so. This completes your chapter, that is function overloading. So in this overall chapter we studied what is function overloading, what is the need of function overloading, restrictions of function overloading. Okay, so and how we are using that function overloading in a as a member of the class. So then inline function, so what exactly is the inline function, what are the advantages of those inline function, then friend function, what is friend function and what are the advantages of this friend function. The main thing in case of friend function is it is a non member function of a class. Non member function means I just I'll give the example. For example, let me take your family itself. Okay, so you have so many friends, so those friends are not from your family, right? So your family member,